Today I'm going to show you how to use an external microphone on your MacBook Pro. I'm sure you've probably tried this and you didn't get it to work, so I'm going to show you how I got mine to work with my MacBook. So the microphone I'm using is this super cheap computer microphone that has a 3.5mm plug on the end of it. Now here's where the real problem comes in. On the MacBook there's only one port on the side and it's labeled for a headphone input. Now most people don't know what to do about this because most computers have a headphone output and a microphone input as separate ports on here, but on the MacBook there's only one port. So I'm going to show you how to easily make your microphone work with this MacBook that only has one port on the side. You will need to buy an accessory to plug your microphone into. I got this thing. It's a StarTech headphone and microphone adapter cable. It's really cheap. I got this on Amazon for $7, and you will need this to be able to plug in your analog microphone that has a 3.5mm jack on it. Now let's get a closer look at this cable and see why we need this. So this is kind of like a standard Y splitter. But actually it's not really standard. If you look on this end, it's got different imprints on here. I don't know if you can see that. See, this one has a headphone symbol on there, and then this one has a microphone symbol on there. So obviously you'll plug your microphone in here, and if you want a headset, you can plug the headset into here, and then this end goes into your computer. One of the major differences in the 3.5mm jack end of this is, you can see this is the end to my microphone. It's got only three sections here. This is called a TRS connector. And then if you take a look at the splitter, this one has four different contact points on here. And this is called a TRRS type connector. And it allows you to split the wiring inside to the separate headphone and microphone jacks right here on this end. So with this cheap adapter, all you have to do is plug in your microphone into the microphone end of the adapter. And now just plug the end of the adapter into the MacBook. And let's try it out with one of my recording programs here. I'm just gonna go ahead and do a quick test here. I'm gonna hit the record button and see what happens. Okay, so it's recording. And as you can see, it's picking up levels from my voice here, but that's because the external microphone is pretty close to me. I should move it a little bit further away. Okay, and then the built-in microphone is right here above the escape key. And if I tap on it, let's see, you don't see any levels popping up on there. And to show you that the external microphone works, I'm going to go ahead and tap on it here in just a second so you can see that the levels are coming from the external microphone. But if I switch sides over here, I'll show you. I've got the microphone plugged in, but I'm going to tap on the built-in microphone and you can see that it is disabled. It's not recording any sounds from there. I'll stop talking for just a second so you can see. So this is a really simple solution to the problem of using an external microphone on a MacBook. As you can see, I just used a simple $7 adapter. It's a TRRS microphone splitter with headphone jack and microphone jack built in. I found it on Amazon, like I said, for only $7, and it really works with the MacBook Pro. One thing I've read in some of the reviews and comments is that some people couldn't get this adapter to work just by plugging in the microphone, so some of them had to plug in their headset to the other side of the port as well. But in my example here, I'm just using the microphone side of the splitter, and it seems to be working just fine with my MacBook. Now when you plug in your headset jack here, basically you're building an entire assembly here with the headphones and the microphone, and talk and listen at the same time. Now, when you do that, you're essentially just building exactly one of these. This is a headphone, a microphone combination that comes with iPhones. Let me show you a closer look at this. So on the volume controls of the iPhone earbuds, you'll see the volume controls here. But on the other side, that little tiny dot you see is the microphone. So basically, this little setup is the same thing we just built with that adapter with a separate headphone and microphone. But on the set of iPhone earbuds, it's all built in. So this is what the end of the iPhone earbuds looks like. It's also a TRRS type connector. If you compare that with the adapter I bought, you'll see that they are the same. They are both TRRS type connectors. They have four contact points on the plug itself. So if you really need to use a microphone on your MacBook and you didn't have that TRRS adapter, you could use your iPhone earbuds temporarily or maybe permanently use the microphone on that for your MacBook. It works just fine, exactly the same way that I just showed you with that adapter with separate microphone and headset. So I'll just give you one final demonstration here. I've got my iPhone earbuds plugged in. I'm going to go ahead and tap on the built-in mic, and I'll show you that it is disabled with that plugged in. And now I'll pick up the microphone end of the earbuds right here. And let's go ahead and tap on this. So the earbuds work just fine with your MacBook as a microphone. You know, if you had one of these lying around, you wouldn't have to buy the adapter. But, you know, with the adapter, you do have the option of using nicer microphones. You may have a microphone lying around that you like to use. If you get the adapter, again, it's a TRRS type adapter. You know, it's really cheap, and it's one of the easiest ways to get a 3.5 millimeter microphone to work with your MacBook. There's a link in the description for the adapter that I'm using here in this video in case you want to try the same one with your MacBook. So I hope you found this video useful, and if you did, please give me a like on this video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more video updates.